Welcome to Odisha, the land of peace, purity and tranquility, and wondrous variety. It's not sun, surf and sand alone that Odisha's sprawling and virginal seashores offer in plenty. The state's astonishing natural resources, consisting of dense and diverse vegetation, rich cultural treasures. Ranging from holy shrines and ancient monuments to unique and signature-bearing handicrafts. In a word, Odisha is a single-stop shop for touristic sights, sounds and services. It is not uncommon for travelers to break into panegyrics on Odisha. Efforts are on to exploit the potential for tourism in Odisha by way of investing in the hospitality sector. Upmarket amenities like swimming pools, bars, scrumptious food, massage parlors, saloons, health clubs, sports, indoor games, discos, multi-cuisine restaurants, themed dhabas, conference halls, luxurious rooms with balconies wide open to the sea, etc., have sprung up almost overnight at the most sought-after tourist destinations, comprising what is known as the Golden Triangle of Bhubaneswar, Puri and Konark. Bhubaneswar, the capital city, is connected with every nook and corner of the country by rail, road and air. Commuting interstate by rail or road is also not a problem. Accommodation is available at all tourist destinations in Odisha at OTDC, Tourism Department, or privately run hotels. Pantho Nivas, Pantho Sala or Jatri Nivas are the best options for budget travelers. These are situated at beautiful locations. A 1 hour journey either by rail or road from Bhubaneswar will take you to Puri. The seashore at Puri is the longest and liveliest. Traditional fishermen known as nuliyas plying their catamarans or sailboats and draw nets with aquatic wealth. Puri is the abode of the Jagannatha temple, a miracle of Kalingan art and one of the four main holy shrines called dhams of the Hindus. Jagannatha Rath Yatra is the main festival of Puri. It is celebrated in the month of June and July. Three big chariots carry the deity of Lord Jagannatha, elder brother Balabhadra and sister Subhadra. Thousands of pilgrims come for darshan and to take the chariots to the Gundicha Ghoro. Staying there for 8 days, the deities come back to Sri Mandir called Baladyolo. After the puja begins the fun time. Tourists enjoy aromatherapy. The Puri beach, dotted with sand sculptures by local artists, is worth seeing. For seafood lovers, tempting dishes of king prawns and crab sold on the beach are a special culinary delight. Then comes the time for shopping from the hawkers on Puri beach and Borodando market. Conches and shell knickknacks, solar pith architecture, pearls and a wide range of gemstones and many more are major attractions. After the last salute, you hit the marine drive, which takes you along the sea tides to the Casuarina-fringed serene Chandrabhaga beach. Here is the magnificent World Heritage Monument, the Sun Temple, Konark, the most enchanting architectural wonder of Odisha. It is a chariot of stone replete with 24 gigantic decorated wheels. Carved sculptures on the spokes narrate various activities of the diurnal round. This 13th century temple has exquisite proportions and delicately executed friezes. The walls of this magnificent ruin have exquisite sculptures covering many aspects of life. The massive monument is a lexicon of the dance form of Odissi. For staying at Konark, there is OTDC's Pantho Nivas and Jatri Nivas of the Department of Tourism, equipped with all necessary facilities. Around an hour's drive from Puri takes you to Chilka, India's largest inland lake. Spread over 1,100 square kilometers, it is an enormous lagoon of brackish water. Chilka is dotted with many emerald islands. Nolobono and the Birds Island are winter resorts for Siberian migratory birds. Tourists come for a glimpse of cavorting dolphins at Satapada, a rare sight in India. To take the blessings of Goddess Kali, you can sail to the Kali Jai Island. For youths, water sport complex of OTDC at Borokolo provides a variety of fun opportunities like pedal boating, canoeing on fiberglass boats, floating, swimming, and enjoying food at the floating restaurant. On your way back, take a peek into the Crafts Museum at Batogaon, Puri, which exhibits specimens of local workmanship. Another 10 minutes drive will take you to Raghurajpur Craft Village, boasting of a gamut of Odissian handicraft, wooden sculptures and leaf paintings. A plan of action is being drawn up in order to develop this extraordinary craft village. Raghurajpur is the birthplace of the Odissi doyen Guru Kelucharano Mohapatro. Another great tradition of this village is the Gotipua dance, the counterpart of Devadasi dance performed by the young boys under guidance of Guru Maguni Das. On the way is Pipli, the applique hub of Odisha. Worth seeing is the aesthetic combination of vibrant colors stitched into an exquisite patchwork. A 20-minute drive from Pipli and you're at Dhauli Stupa, the Buddhist monument known as Vishwasanti Stupa, where the Kalinga war was fought and the river Daya turned red with the blood of 100,000 soldiers. This transformed Emperor Ashoka into the compassionate Ashoka. An Ashokan rock edict is situated at Dhauli. The sculpted elephant atop the edict signifies the Mauryan Emperor Ashoka's conversion to Buddhism. A peace park is also developed here. In a few minutes, you will be at Bhuvaneshwar, the temple city, being metamorphosed into the capital city. The most attractive monument for Hindu pilgrims is the Lingaraj Temple, a masterpiece of Kalingan architecture. You can have darshan of Lord Lingaraj and take prasad, a variety of nutritious and delicious dishes cooked in earthen pots and served in the traditional way on banana leaves. In Bhuvaneshwar, other must-see temples are Parshurameshwaro, Swaranjaleshwaro, Mukteshwaro, Vaital, Chonsat Jogini and Rajarani temples. Bhuvaneshwar has a monumental Jain complex at Khandagiri Udaygiri Caves. The followers of Mahavir come here to attain spiritual upliftment and others to admire its classic architecture. The double-storied Rani Gumpha, the Queen's Cave, is the largest cave with ornate carvings. The Hathi Gumpha, Elephant Cave, has the chronicle of King Kharobelo carved on it. Bhuvaneshwar has the best-known wildlife destination in Odisha, Nandankanan, the Garden of the Gods, known especially for its white tiger safari. Bhuvaneshwar is rapidly growing into a cosmopolis. There are so many amusement centers and parks to cater to your evening fun and entertainment. Ekam Rohat is a place for cost-effective handicraft shopping. The highlights are terracotta, dhokra casting, ikat, bomkai, tassar, handloom textiles, pottachitra, silver filigree works, pipli applique works, paper mache masks, and a lot more. One can also enjoy a typical Odissi cuisine. The Diamond Triangle, consisting of Ratnagiri, Lalitagiri, Udayagiri, is only 100 kilometers from Bhubaneswar. These hills are a remarkable Buddhist complex. Extensive ruins of brick pagodas, sculptured stone portals, and esoteric Buddhist images testifying to ancient glory have been unearthed here. Ratnagiri is the gem of this complex. Development of the Buddhist circuit is the major focus for the tourism department. At Langudi Hill rock-cut caves, exquisite Buddhist sculptures can be seen. It is a recently discovered site. You can stay here at Patharajpur Ponthasala. Odisha is a veritable treasure trove of undiscovered tourist attractions. What we have shown here is only the tip of the proverbial iceberg. We hope it serves as an invitation and an appeal to you to come and explore it to your heart's content. For details, visit our website www.orissatourism.gov.in.